He said, first, do you think if you stay at your home, you are safe from death? If the time comes, your death, everyone's death is written before we created. So if your time is come, even if you are in death, if you are asleep, even if you are in praying, any time, any situation, everything has written.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين إن الذين تولوا منكم يوم التقى الجمعان إنما استزلهم الشيطان ببعض ما كسبوا ولقد عفى الله عنهم إن الله غفور حليم يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تكونوا كالذين كفروا وقالوا لإخوانهم إذا ضربوا في الأرض أو كانوا غزا لو كانوا عندنا ما ماتوا وما قتلوا ليجعل الله ذلك حسرة في قلوبهم والله يحيي ويميت والله يحيي ويميت والله بما تعملون بصير ولئن قتلتم في سبيل الله أو متتم لمغفرة من الله ورحمة خير مما يجمعون ولئن متتم أو قتلتم لإلى الله تحشرون
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وقدوتنا وقائدنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله وخيرته من خلقه وخليله اللهم صل وسلم على عبدك وحبيبك ونبيك ورسولك سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. We still reflect upon the battle of Uhud, which is the second main passage of Surah Ali Imran. And yesterday we talked about some of the main lessons of this battle. And we continue because Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala has mentioned a lot of lessons in this battle because, as we said, the lessons of defeat is more important than the lessons of victory. As in English they say, in victory there has 100 fathers, but defeat is orphan. So in victory is easy, everyone then will be happy, will joy, but when you face defeat, you need a lot of lessons, especially if you are a believer. Because maybe some believers, they thought Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala promised us, if we are in His path, He will help us. And Allah never break His promise. However, the problem is from our side. That's why this surah went to focus on this. When the last time, yesterday we talked about the Prophet ﷺ, if he die or killed, you should carry on. This is the path of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. After that, he said, وَكَأَيِّمْ مِن نَبِيٍّ قَاتَلَ مَعَهُ رِبِّيُّونَ كَثِيرٌ Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala had chosen you to be the companion of the last and best prophet. Bear in mind that the prophets before you, they have a lot of followers. And their followers, they were very firm and they tried to sacrifice everything to protect their prophet. Allah called them Ribbiyun. Ribbiyun come from the word Rabb, Lord. It means Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala make this connection. They said, this is my servant. What's the characteristics of those servants? Which Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala give us example. They made a dua, four parts of this dua. In this dua, Allah will summarize also and emphasize the lesson again. These Ribbiyun, when they face any enemy, they start to raise their hands to their Lord. The lesson here is, وَمَن نَصْرُ إِلَّا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ. Victory just come just from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. So they raise their hands and they start their supplication. رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا ذُنُوبَنَا. Look how Allah addressed this profound lesson. They are now will face their enemy. Their first supplication is not, oh Allah, help us or give us victory. No. Oh Allah, forgive our sins. Subhanallah. Why? Because the main reason for defeat is the internal factors. It's our sins. Because Allah had made promise. If you are in the path of Allah, you will gain victory, always. If you don't gain victory, it means there's some problem from your side. So they start before they seek help from Allah. Oh Allah, forgive our sins. Because our sins is prevent us from victory. He will say in another ayah also in Uhud, أَوَلَمَّا أَصَابَتْكُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَدْ أَصَبْتُمْ مِثْلَيْهَا. They said, we won in Uhud. What happened in Badr? In Badr we had victory. What's going on in Uhud? Allah said, قُلْ هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ أَنفُسِكُمْ. That's from your side. So they said, رِبِّيُونَ رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا ذُنُوبَنَا. Then, وَإِسْرَافَنَا فِي أَمْرِنَا. إِسْرَاف, when فِي أَمْرِ. إِسْرَاف, it means when you exceed a limit. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala give you a lot of permissible things in this dunya. The rule is everything permissible is permissible except few things. Zawaj is permissible. But some people exceed the limit and go to haram relationship. There is a lot of ways to gain halal money. But some people exceed the limit and go to haram ways. And so on. So, إِسْرَافَنَا فِي أَمْرِنَا. Oh Allah, maybe we are not deserve this victory because we exceed the limit a lot in the past. Forgive us for that. And subhanAllah, even when you exceed the limit, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala made another ayah. He said, Allah said the another ayah, يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا. Oh my servant who exceed the limit, لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. Don't despair of the mercy of Allah. Don't give up. Don't lose hope. Allah is the most merciful, the all forgiving. Then the supplication continue. اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وثبت أقدامنا. Establish our feet firm. Because in Uhud they run away from the battlefield. ثبت أقدامنا. It means the courage, it's just also from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. You will face a lot of difficulties in this life. The only one can help you to stay firm is Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Then in the end of supplication, وَانْصُرْنَا. Seek for victory is the last thing. Because victory is the promise of Allah. The problem is our side. Then Allah comment after this supplication, فَآتَاهُمُ اللَّهُ ثَوَابَ الدُّنْيَا وَحُسْنَا. He didn't say وَثَوَابَ الْآخِرَةِ. ثَوَابَ الدُّنْيَا didn't say وَثَوَابَ الْآخِرَةِ. He add a word here, وَحُسْنَ ثَوَابِ الْآخِرَةِ. Another lesson.
ثواب الدنيا is nothing. ثواب الدنيا is this worldly. If Allah give you in this world any reward, it's just in this temporary. Temporary. If Allah give you everything in this life, still temporary. And always you have stress, worry about this ni'mah here in this world. But ثواب الآخرة حسن ثواب الآخرة. Excellent. It's forever. Peace. Everything you wish. So he comment in the dua, compare between dunya and akhirah. This is introduction, because he will say after a while, minkum man yuridu dunya wa minkum man yuridu al-akhirah. Some of you in ghazwa, in battle of Uhud, they want to gain dunya and some want to gain akhirah. So that's the profound lesson here. The another also lesson, that some munafiqeen, when they heard the news of Uhud, they say, if the believers stay with us, they would not killed. That's not in the battle of Uhud. That's every time, even nowadays. If any people they want to defend, they said, oh, why they want to kill themselves? If they stay with us, they would not killed. Allah made a lot of commentary on this. He said, first, do you think if you stay at your home, you are safe from death? قُلْ لَوْ كُنْتُمْ فِي بُيُوتِكُمْ لَبَرَزَ الَّذِينَ كُتِبَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْقَتْلُ إِلَى مَضَاجِعِهِمْ. If the time comes, your death, everyone's death is written before we created. So if your time is come, even if you are in death, if you are asleep, even if you are in praying, any time, any situation, everything has written. So don't think if you go in the path of Allah, that will make you close to the death. Or if you stay at home, it's you are far away from death. Because death is, this is just the qadar of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Wallahu yuhyi wa yumit. Wallahu bima ta'amaluna basir. Life and death is just in the hand of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Then he tell us, change your aspect about death and life. وَلَئِن قُتِلْتُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَوْ مُتْتُمْ لَمَغْفِرَةٌ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَرَحْمَةٌ خَيْرٌ مِّمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. Do you think those 70 people who killed in Uhud, they lost? If we just can see the barrier between us and them, the border between dunya and akhirah, we'll see different aspect. They are overjoyed. They waiting for us to be with them. يَسْتَبْشِرُونَ بِالَّذِينَ لَمْ يَلْحَقُوا بِهِ مِنْ خَلْفِهِمْ. They are in Jannah. They are very happy. They say, when? When will our brothers will join us? And we are in this dunya, say, oh, they are masakin, they lost, look at them. So Allah wants to change our aspect. وَلَئِن مُتْتُمْ أَوْ قُتِلْتُمْ لَإِلَى اللَّهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. So this is also another profound lesson. May Allah تبارك وتعالى give us deep understanding to his book. اللَّهُ عَلَمُ وَصَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَى عَبْدِهِ رَسُولِهِ سَيِّدْنَا.